Yaakov, and welcome to this first lesson about the blues. You may not know that, but the first thing I played on the guitar was a blues. I got my first guitar with a cassette of Django Reinhardt and a large record collection with all the biggest stars in the blues from my big brother. And the first thing he taught me to play was the blues. And that blues followed me during all those years that I am playing. A lot of us started to play guitar from the blues, playing one pentatonic scale all over the fingerboard. And how hard it is to make the transition from playing one pentatonic scale to improvise in jazz, giving each chord its own sound. So I'm going to cover this and show you how I started making this transition in with the blues. But there are other guitarists who came from the classical world or from jazz, and they just want to sound more bluesy. So I will give you tips how to sound more bluesy in this lesson too. Like in all of my other lessons, in this lesson too, we are going to start from the very basics. I want to make sure that we all have a common background. We'll start from the pentatonic, the minor and the major blues scales. I want to make sure you know it. And then we're going to get to a very high level of playing. We are going to play substitutes over the 1-6-2-5 progression. This is something that was a mystery for me for a lot of years, and I could only figure it out in the blues because the sound was so basic. So let's hear what we are going to cover in this lesson. First, let's play the first 12 bar blues in the key of G. I will play the chords G13, but you can use G7 if you prefer, C7 and 9, but you can play C7 if you prefer, and D7 and 9. And you can play D7 if you prefer. Let's play the progression together so we make sure we have the same 12 bar blues. We start with G13, G, 2, 3, 4, C, 2, 3, 4, G, 2 bars, C, 2, 3, 4, 2 bars, and G, 2 bars. To play the minor, the minor blues pentatonic over the entire progression. It sounds like that. All right, you know this sound, but in jazz there is a key element that for each chord we want to give its own sound. And for doing that, we can start only with pentatonic, but we will add another pentatonic, the major pentatonic or the major blues pentatonic. We will play this major pentatonic over the chord G and the minor pentatonic over the other two chords. And this is the starting of giving each chord its own sound and following the changes, knowing exactly on which chord we are playing. This is the very first and easy step that you can do. Let's hear the major pentatonic scale. And let's hear when I play it over the G and the minor over the other chord. We start with G major, minor, and major. Now, minor pentatonic. And minor again. Alright? So let's make a quick review on the two scales. G is our first degree, B flat flat third degree, 4 degree is the note C, D is the fifth degree, and F is the flat seventh degree, and between the fourth and the fifth degree we have the blue note, which makes it the blues scale. So the complete position and the blue note again here, minor pentatonic on the minor blues scale. And for the major pentatonic, it's the same thing as playing E minor pentatonic, which is what we play here for G, but starting from G. So let's see, we have G as the root, A as the 9, the second degree, or as the 9. We have B as the 3rd degree, D as the 5th degree, and E as the 6th degree. So it's like a major 6 and 9 arpeggio with the blue note B flat as a approach to the 3rd degree. So all together the scale goes like that. Combination of the minor and the major blues scale over the progression, blues progression, gives you the starting point to follow the changes and to give each chord its own sound. So remember, for G, play the major and major blues pentatonic, and for C and D, play the minor or the minor blues pentatonic. And let's hear again how it sounds. Minor, major, now minor, now major, minor, now after we know how to make the first steps in playing over the form, giving each chord its unique sound and sounding bluesy on the way, I want to move to something else. It's much more advanced. It's about playing substitutes to the 1-6-2-5 progression. Now I will change the key because you need to know the blues in all keys, and it's fun to play the blues each time in a different key, and I want you to get used to it. So now we will play the blues in C, all right? And I will show you a progression, the chord progressions that we use in gypsy jazz. So first, let's see the chords. In addition to the 13 chord or 7 and 9 chord we saw earlier in this lesson, now we have a minor 7 chord. You can play D minor 7 here with D, C, F and A, or three fingers, or in this shape, D, F, C, and F again. Now let's play the chord progression. C, F, C, G minor 7, C, F, minor 7 chord to D minor 7, G7, and the turnaround C, A, D minor, and G. Let's take a closer look at the 1-6-2-5 at the turnaround C, and then A7, D minor, and G. you can also play it C, 7, A, D minor, and G. The basic turnaround is not so bluesy to my ears. But when we add the substitutes that I'm going to show you, we get a bluesy sound. Listen to this. Because the substitutes give us like blue notes. Listen to this. So let's dig into all those substitutes. The first thing we want to do is to make all our chords as dominant chords that will lead one to another. It means that for each chord we are going to build a secondary dominant, and I will explain it to you. It's very simple. We treat every chord in this situation as our target, and we want to build some tension that will resolve, that will lead to this chord. How we do it? We play a chord that leads to it before him. So if we want to play the chord C, we will tension to it. It means we play its fifth degree, the chord that sits on its fifth degree. So C, D, E, F, G. You want to create tension that will lead into C, you need to play the chord G. It's the fifth degree, 7. So we already have it. G7 leads to C. Okay. D7 is the fifth degree of D minor. It's okay. D, E, F, G, A. You see, A is the fifth degree. We have A7. We already have it. But D minor does not lead to G minor, to G. D is the fifth degree of G. G, A, B, C, D. So this is okay. We have the fifth degree, but we want it to be dominant. D7, that leads to G. We want to build this tension. Okay, so we change D7 to G. So the turnaround became C, A7, D7, and C7. Okay, that's why we play 7 chords all the time, because we want them to lead one to another. And then we get to the second substitute that we are going to use a lot, which is the sub 5. Instead of playing chord A, for example, I can play a chord, a different dominant chord that sits on its tritone. It means that you need just to see this shape. This is A, this is the tritone, the shape. Here, this is A, this is the tritone. It's the same shape wherever you look. If you play up or down, it's the same thing. So just learn this shape of the tritone, and this is our substitutes. For each dominant chord, you have E7, you can play B7 instead. Okay? You have B7, you can play E7 instead. They substitute one another. So in our blues, we have C and A7. So instead of A7, I will play E flat, and all the rest I will keep the same. So the first thing is to play C, E flat, D, and G. Alright? See, it's not so complicated. And now you can understand why you see those chords. C and E flat instead of A. D, we had it already, and G. If we'll see it here, is C7, E flat instead of A, and then G and D as we had in the beginning. Alright, now let's make secondary dominant to other chords. We already substitute the D. Now let's substitute the chord G. Instead of playing G, where is our sub 5? Here. D flat. G, sub 5 is Here, you see this shape? D flat. So we have C, E flat instead of A, D instead of D, it's the same chord, and D flat instead of G. So we are getting this kind of turnaround. Right? Or if you play it here, C, D flat, D, D flat, C. So we already have two options. C, D flat, D, G, or D flat, D, D flat. I remind you, because we made a substitute. Instead of A7, we played D, E flat, and instead of G, we played D flat. Now let's try to substitute other chords. We can start with C, move to A, and then we can substitute the D7. What is the sub 5 for D7? You just play this shape. Here is the substitutes. Instead of playing D, we'll need to play A flat, or here, D, A flat. You see, it's the same shape. So, after C and A, we will have A flat instead of D, and then G. So the whole progression goes like that. C, A, A flat instead of D, and G. So see how many options we have already. C, A, A flat, G, or C, D flat, So now you can play with all those options and create your movements, but I want to show you even more, because it's fun, it's like a game. You know, we can substitute the note C, the chord C, with its inversion, which with C over E. Let's see it here. It's like C7, but we take the notes from the first string and put it on the bass. E, C, G, and C again. So we can play, instead of C, we have the substitute, the inversion, C over E. And then we can play C over E, A, G, D7, and G7. Or all the substitutes, E flat, D flat, D and D flat, or C, A, D flat, G. Okay, everything we played with C, we can play with C over E. Now I want to expand this idea. Instead of playing C over E, I will play E dominant, E7. Why? Because E7 leads to A. All right? A, B, C, D, E. E is the fifth degree, so we will make a secondary dominant, E7, that leads us to A. So the progression became, instead of C, A, B, and G, now we have E, A, B, and G. Now let's substitute the chord E. We'll make a sub 5. Here is the shape. So instead of E, we are going to play B flat 7. Now I want you to remember, E was instead of C. Now instead of E, we play B flat. So B flat is instead of C. So the turnaround will be like that. B flat 7, A, D, and G. Now you can play all the other substitutes that you have, but starting with B flat instead of C. So I will give you all the options now for the 1, 6 to 5. I'll start with B flat, E flat, you see all the options? together. Now I will show you my coolest substitutes for 1/6 to 5. I play instead of C, B flat, and then A, and then A flat, and then G. But I don't play regular 7 chord. I play B flat 7 flat 5, A 7 sharp 5, A flat 7 flat 5, and G 7 sharp 5. For B flat, I take my 5th degree on the 2nd string and I flatten it. Then I have B flat flat 5. And then I take A 7 and sharp 5. Alright? I sharpen it. And the same thing for A flat. I take the 5th degree half tone below and then F A flat flat 5 and then G 7 sharp 5. It sounds like that. Thank you.